Tonight, the biggest getaway ever. Join us for an exclusive epic journey on the world's largest luxury liner, the Queen Mary 2. And your chance to win the ultimate holiday afloat.
An absolutely mammoth show. We are on the Queen Mary 2, the biggest cruise ship ever built. The size and the luxury of this superliner is staggering. And over the next half an hour, we will give you a personal tour from port to starboard, bow to stern, and all stops in between. But the best news is that later in the show, I will give you details as to how you can win the cruise of a lifetime on board this very baby from New York to London, and we will throw in some business class air tickets to get you there. But right now, I think about 300 metres that way on the observation deck is that old salt David Reyne to tell us just how big the QM2, as she is known, really is. David.
Old salt I may be, but it doesn't make me any the wiser. I'm one of these people that can't quite comprehend how jumbos can fly and how big ships can float. And not only is this the largest cruise ship to ever slice through the waves, it's also the longest, the tallest, and the widest. And I'm only really comforted by the fact that at $1 billion, she's also the most expensive. I'm just hoping they got the figures right.
The QM2 is as long as 41 double-decker London buses, or about 3.5 times longer than Big Ben is high, and 44 metres taller than the Eiffel Tower. There are 10 venues in which to dine, 5 indoor and outdoor pools in which to splash, the only floating planetarium, the largest library at sea, and the largest ballroom on the ocean, all for the pleasure of 2,620 passengers.
And another thing, when this queen purses her lips to blow her whistle, she can be heard 16 kilometres away. Begs the question, why? And while I'm at it, why does Catriona seem to have such a nice room?
Now my bet is that you are going to want to see the accommodation first up, because that is what you do when you first board. You go and check out your cabin. Well, it goes without saying that there are various levels of accommodation on board the QM2, and this is what is known as the Grand Duplex. Let's just dream a little bit. This is the best of the best. Nothing surpasses what we have here. And how much will it set you back? Well, a transatlantic crossing will cost you $50,000 per person. I'll say that once more for dramatic effect. $50,000 per person. So, what do you get for that? Well, your own personal butler for starters. You will dine in the top restaurant on board. Queues do not exist for you. And this suite, well, it is absolutely amazing. Two levels, as you can probably tell. There's an entertainment system, mini bar, two bathrooms. The one in here has a jacuzzi, and there is a kitchen downstairs. But of course, you don't have to worry about that because you have your own butler. The ship has a massive 1,310 cabins of various shapes and sizes. And the good news, nearly three quarters of them have balconies. Now, with all due respect to this cabin, this is the next step down. This is called the Princess Grill accommodation. And I think you can tell straight away that the most obvious difference is size, but it's still lovely. You've got a private balcony, a walk-in wardrobe, and you get to share with only a handful of other guests your own private concierge. But don't be disheartened if it all looks too expensive. On the cruise that we took from Miami to Central America, a cabin like Mr. Reyne's cost about $350 per person a night. Now that is pretty good. When you consider that gets you all your meals, the run of the ship, and the same first-class treatment.
I cried last night. I was so happy because I'm just treated like a queen.
You are treated in a very special way. And the staff, they're there for everything that you want.
After the break, we're going to sample some of the 40,000 different activities on board and defend the ship from pirates!
way not here. There's plenty to do on the QM2. You can play golf, shuffleboard, darts, basketball, tennis, gym, spa, jogging, swimming, lectures, library, kids club, art gallery, art auctions, bridge, yoga, meditation, Pilates, bingo, trivia comps, of course, dance classes, horse racing, the renewal of wedding vows, and chat, knit, and stitch gatherings. This needn't be your snooze cruise or your booze cruise. This could be your pay your dues cruise, shed your blues cruise, what have you got to lose cruise.
It seems the choice is too much for some who'd rather work on their tan or devour a book around one of the four pools. And there's no mad scramble for sun loungers on this ship. There are more than enough to go around. There is also an indoor option for those who'd rather bask in air-conditioned comfort. Meanwhile, down on deck three, the ladies' auxiliary is in session.
I've joined the Chat, Knit and Stitch Club. Try saying that three times. It wasn't actually on the original agenda, but the ship found there were so many women who were asking, where's the knitting club? Of course, that they've introduced one.
Strangely enough, this club has proven to be a slow starter with the male guests.
I've had some men come to my napkin folding and some very enthusiastic gentlemen came to my scarf tying.
Of course.
Okay, so the world's biggest cruise ship doesn't have a golf course as such, but there's more than one way you can get a game.
Oh, that is a 300-metre drive with a 7-iron all the way to Cuba.
I decide to work on my swing too. Only this time, excuse me, I am playing at St. Andrews on a state-of-the-art golf simulator.
Bad girl!
The ship is really the destination, so wherever she sails is quite a bonus, and you will find most guests putting up their hand for just about anything.
8,005 is
their
nine.
There's a supersized workout area, not to mention the largest spa afloat.
Pirates, are you ready?
British nannies, of course, have been shipped in to run the play zone for junior cruisers, leaving you free to spend time working on your bling bling.
You get me.
I've just learned that tonight the captain is holding a masked ball. So to save myself from social embarrassment, I've signed up for a dance class. The only problem I had was which one to choose. There's cha-cha, foxtrot, swing, waltz, and the one I'm going for is rumba. Yeah. This is Jason, he's Australian.
Hi there, welcome aboard.
Very Latin, very romantic. Not you, the dance.
Now, I have to tell you that at times like these, there doesn't seem to be enough men to go around. But that doesn't stop the enthusiasm to bop.
Slow, quick, quick, slow.
When it comes to transportation, I like to know who's driving me, who's flying me, or in this case, steering me around the ocean. Paul Wright is the captain of the QM2, and a jolly good captain he is too.
You're obviously been at sea for most of your life.
No, I just came yesterday. Yeah. No, I'm only kidding.
Right. Sorry. This would have to be the ultimate position for a captain, the ultimate ship for a captain. Would that be right?
Yes, I think that's fair to say. I think you'll find most of these guys' ambition is to be there, and I don't walk down the stairs in front of them.
Yeah, you've got to watch your back.
That's right, yeah.
We've already established that the QM2 is the biggest ship in the world, but the battle for that title has kept shipbuilders busy for decades. The age of the superliner began with the launch of Cunard's QE2 in 1969, but the competition got really serious with the cruising boom of the 90s. Until our big queen came along this year, Royal Caribbean held the title with its monster fleet of five Voyager-class ships. They remain number two. Rounding out the top five are the Carnival Conquest at number three. At number four, P&O's grand-class Princess ships, which include the Star Princess, which visited Australia this summer. And at number five, the Italian Job, launched last November, the aptly named Costa Fortuna.
After the
the break. Food, lashings of it, endlessly, 24/7, that's 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, across the seven seas.
Welcome back. Now, there are people in this world for whom the highlight of cruising is the food. Just wandering from one great feast to the next, happy to leave the ship at the end with an extra roll or two, and, you know, I'm not talking baguettes. Naturally, Cunard pride themselves on offering you a culinary experience. There are 10 restaurants here for you to choose from. This is the Britannia, three stories high, the biggest wine collection afloat in the world. It's elegant, it's opulent, and for those of us who care, offering a delicious range of low-cal options. Everybody can eat at Britannia. In fact, only two of the 10 restaurants on board have access restricted to top-end passengers. So no matter which level of accommodation you're on, you will have a table reserved for you for breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
If the big plate, small food option ain't your thing, go to the buffet. The smorgasbord, the queue and chew, the eat until you beat. Go ahead, pile it on, you've paid already.
The King's Court serves up four different cuisines to whet the appetite. There's the carvery, the Asian kitchen, variety Italian style, and the chef's daily fancy, which seems to be a more DIY approach to dining.
Finding it a real challenge tracking down a good cup of coffee. But clearly, that is of no consequence to the hordes in here who are enjoying high tea in the winter garden. No tea bags allowed. If you skimped on dessert at lunch, you crazy thing, you can make up for it every afternoon at 3 o'clock in the winter garden where flowers bloom all year round and the sweetie treats just keep on coming.
And of course there's my favourite, the liquid lunch, but if you're looking for something more substantial, there is pub grub here. But I'm quite happy with the steak and two eggs you find in every glass of Guinness.
If I may say so, we have had some pretty hot competitions on Getaway. Personally, I didn't think we could top those Concorde tickets, but we have done it. It is safe to say that this competition that I'm about to announce is the biggest and the best we have ever put on offer. We are giving you the chance to win a transatlantic cruise on this very ship, the Queen Mary 2, from New York to London. And of course, we will give you business class air tickets to get you there and back. Okay, here is the deal. Listen closely. You and a friend will be booked into a deluxe balcony stateroom on the QM2 for its New York to London cruise on April 22 next year. A Qantas will fly you business class, which of course will feature Skybed on all of its Australia-London flights by the end of May. Now these comfy capsules are rolling out progressively on other Qantas international routes. Not only that, but we will put you up for two nights at the very swanky Peninsula Hotel in New York and three nights at the equally unbelievable Ritz Hotel in London. Plus, we will throw in $5,000 spending money, $5,000. To enter, call 1902-553-696 or SMS your name and address to 188-7596. Now, entries close midnight Sunday and you can enter as many times as you like. Go for it. How good is that? I told you it was hot. Now, if you missed any of the numbers, don't you worry about a thing. You just stay tight in that deck chair. We'll be repeating them later in the show. Get ready. After the break, we are going to a masquerade ball. So you get your mask and I'll just finish off in the shower.
Whatever may come, the world keeps revolving. They say the next big thing is here, that the revolution's near. But to me it seems quite clear that it's all just a little bit of history repeat.
It would
would be irresponsible of me not to point out that there are some fairly flamboyant, some fairly theatrical and some surgically enhanced individuals cruising with the Queen this evening. And you know what? I've got a feeling we haven't seen anything yet.
First, I must collect my date for this evening.
You look like $1 million and some change.
All dressed up and only one place to go, the Queen's Room, which naturally is home to the largest ballroom afloat. The ship has a strict dress code, and two out of three nights you'll find yourself donning the black tie and maybe even a mask. You will come across some cruisers who take their dancing very seriously. And others like me who rather enjoy the action from the sidelines, but not Ms. Rowntree. She can't help herself.
I'm doing my best to put my dancing lessons to good use, but I am sorry. Some of these steps I just haven't seen before. Finally, I convinced Davo to come on out for a spin. And you know what? It turns out that he's also got a few moves that I have never seen before. Desperately in need of refreshment, we head for the nearest bar, as you do, and with seven on board, we don't have very far to go. The Chart Room Bar has live music nightly with an, well, it's an intimate atmosphere, perfect for high seas romance. Time for a quick photo opportunity.
I then escape to my favourite night spot, Churchill's Cigar Lounge.
Here you are. Enjoy, sir.
Thank you. My dear sir, how appropriate. Thank you. As Catriona doesn't indulge, she's plotting our next port of call. And it's payback time as she drags me onto the dance floor of the G32 nightclub. Although I don't even have time to warm up. Whisked away. And as the music regresses into the 70s, it seems as a dance partner, I'm not of the right persuasion. So I'm left to YMCA in my seat.
Like me, if you love these kind of environments, well, we have everything organized for you. Here is how we get you on board.
For bookings or further information, contact your local travel agent or Cunard Line on 1-800-029-956 or www.cunardline.com.au. Now, for a fact sheet, you can also log on to our website at 9msn.com.au, or how about you write to us at PO Box 50, Willoughby 2068. Now, cruises are scheduled up until November 2005. Australia, at this point, isn't on the itinerary yet, but berths are available on Transatlantic, Mediterranean, Caribbean, Canadian and New England departures. But of course, if the ship can't come to you, we could be taking you to the ship. Again, here are the numbers for our unbelievable QM2 competition. To enter, just call 1902 553 696 or SMS your name and address to 188-7596. And this is what you could win. It's amazing. A six-night cruise on the QM2 from New York to London. Two nights at the very swanky Peninsula Hotel in New York and three nights at the equally fabulous Ritz Hotel in London to die for. And you will fly Qantas Business Class, which will feature the comfy sky bed on all of its Australia London flights by the end of May, and other routes will follow. Oh, did I mention we will also give you $5,000 spending money? Let's go shopping.
We all hope that you have enjoyed sailing the high seas with us.
There you go.
Oh, thank you.
Sink that? Probably not the most appropriate thing to say on a boat.
Until we next meet. Ahoy there.
See you later.
Bon voyage.